suddenly appeared on the catwalk on the starboard side of the bridge, rapping anxiously on the window. His face was unusually serious. Okay. His shouts were nearly inaudible given the thickness of the glass, and he quickly resorted to simply pointing to something off the starboard bow. Sparky grabbed a brass telescope.
That's good, that's good.
In the direction of the aerial marine's gesture. Coming through the arched entrance of the airship port was an undulating wave of dust. Oh, I bet you can make one of those. Okay. And a shape of golden color was rushing onto the airfield. Through her telescope, Sparky recognized dozens of grass creatures that were scurrying at top speed. She shouted, "Impact! Coming his way!" Her first thought was to wonder how the impacts had found them and what destruction they could cause on the broken hair. Yvonne's face screwed up into a quizzical look, and he said, "What is that? Ipecac? Yvonne's be sick?" Sparky grabbed the voice pipe that led to the cabin hallway and shouted, "Drake! Drake! To the starboard side! Impact!" The chief inspector was just making his exit from Lord Ashley's cabin when he heard the strange news, dampened and echoey plea, and sprinted to the main hall leading to the external door. Outside on the catwalk, he quickly joined Sergeant Fox. "Where are they?" Erasmus shouted, the slight breeze of the evening air at this altitude making it hard to hear. The sergeant pointed, but followed with his own question, "What are they?" Erasmus replied loudly, "Tunneling and excavation contraptions. We not only encountered them just outside Paris, but ended up capturing a couple." Sergeant, be prepared. Sergeant Fox raised an eyebrow for an instant, but showed no more surprise than that.